All right. So good morning. Glad to be with you, talking about you and your business like we do every day. And guess what? It's already Friday. Time goes fast when you're having fun. We've got a guest on here today. Cool company. One that's getting a lot of props, enjoying enormous growth. Cloud management company out of the Vienna, Virginia area, called Cetrom. And I have the president and CEO of that company, Chris Stark, on the program. Welcome, Chris.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Glad to have you on the company. On the program. Kind of give us that overview of your company, kind of the elevator speech, if you will.
Cetrom is a private company based out of the Washington, D.C. area. We provide cloud solutions for SMBs across the United States, focusing on a more customized cloud solution and an emphasis on security.
Okay. SMB, small to medium businesses?
Exactly. The more or less it represents about 90% of the market, SMBs, and we focus on several verticals: accounting firms, associations, law firms, federal government contractors, and entertainment companies.
So let me ask you then, what would be a large company for you to work with?
Largest companies right around the 1,500 mark or so, 1,500 employees. We measure our clients by how many employees they are, not revenue.
So it's kind of just on the brink of an enterprise level.
Exactly. However, some of these small companies are actually in the enterprise space, and they're in the, we'll call it the billion-dollar club. So it's
fooled by the number of employees, in other words.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, so that's cool. Do you want to do bigger? Do you want to have bigger clients, or do you consider this a neglected area that needs more attention?
This is an area that we're very comfortable in. It's a niche market that there's a need and there's still a void for growth and for expertise in. It's definitely that we've been doing that in this space for about 13 years or so, and we understand some of the unique challenges as they're going through the growth of their company, whether it be 25 employees and they're graduating into that 100 or 200 employee mark. There's major milestones and challenges they have to overcome. Some of the challenges of these smaller companies are very unique than the larger companies.
Let me ask you, so you're Inc. 500. Where are you on that list? Or the Inc. 5000, where are you on that list?
Off the top of my head, we're right around the 3,000-something. I apologize. I don't know the number off the top of my head.
Yeah, no problem. I appreciate that. And that's a cool list to be a part of. So how's 2013 been? It sounds like the last 3 years have been phenomenal.
The last 3 years have been amazing. Actually, the last 4 or 5 years have been amazing. When we started doing cloud 13 years ago, one of the challenges we had were just the people understanding the technology and the business model. Now the marketing has really caught up. The market's matured, and people are recognizing global, being mobile and BYOD and being on the road and being able to adapt and outsourcing is a huge plus, and they're recognizing that some of the security challenges they thought they had aren't really there.
By the way, a lot of your, a lot of our audience are in vernaculars, in verticals rather that you're looking for, but they don't know what acronyms like BYOD mean. So you might want to help us with a little bit of the lingo. So, and I'm pretty good on the lingo, but I'm not sure what some of these mean. BYOD.
Bring your own device.
Bring your own device. Okay.
Yes.
So
sure.
It's okay. We have enough time for you to actually say the whole words where some of these acronyms and others could be questionable. So, yeah. And so it's an area that you just have grown into. How old is the company, by the way?
13 years.
13 years. And were you the founder or how long have you been with it?
I am the founder and the original entrepreneur that started the company 13 years ago. I'm also one of the original architect of the backbone system of the technology solution.
Okay, and kind of tell us what exactly that technology solution does.
Say that one more time.
Kind of give us an overview of what the services are that you provide.
So we host applications and data for our clients. What we do is enable them to outsource and completely rid themselves of the burden of some of the more information technology challenges they have today. For example, every business in today's market usually has email needs. They have accounting applications. They have an application they're using, office automation. They have data needs. And they also just need somebody to kind of call at 2 o'clock in the morning if there's a problem or a guidance, if you will, on what the best next thing they should be doing. And that's what we provide to our clients is that turnkey solution providing the applications, the infrastructure, i.e. all the servers, the support, the design build, the guidance, kind of the virtual CIO role, if you will, for our client base.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And so you're kind of an extension of do you actually service the extension of technology, not of a company's technology department? Are you something of an extension of that?
Absolutely. We've become really involved with our clients. I mean, it's more of a partnership than a client-vendor relationship. It's really getting to know our client base, understanding their unique needs, and where they're trying to go tomorrow, what's the five-year growth, not just from a financial side, but plan employees, geographical challenges they may be having, technologies they're trying to evaluate, and understanding their business needs, and then coming to them with a turnkey solution with the set of applications, the set of security that they need, and the support they need, and then we deliver that as a turnkey solution. So we really become, heavily involved in the process of evaluating.
Yeah, sounds interesting. And how did you end up in the Northern Virginia area? Because obviously you have a national presence.
Yes. So it just, we're headquartered out of here. This is, where I kind of grew up, and went to college off somewhere else, but then came back to the area, and that's where just decided to set up shop. It wasn't necessarily a vision of what Virginia was the place to be, but it was just kind of happened that way.
Yeah, Virginia is a great part of the country. I love Virginia, actually. I actually lived there for a couple of years and really enjoyed it, and liked the end of Virginia in particular. I remember that area. And so that's kind of cool. And, from a geographical perspective, are there certain parts of the country that you serve in greater abundance than others?
Well, being headquartered out of the East Coast, a lot of our clients, majority of our clients are in the East Coast, up and down the seaboard here, but we do have clients in 40 different other states. So because the web is accessible from anywhere, our applications and our solutions accessible from anywhere. Also, we have clients that have other offices outside of the United States, up into Canada, into China, into Australia. And then we have employees of our companies that are traveling all over the world. They're accessing their systems. So really in getting into an international space. However, most of, because of the organic growth of the company, we started out in East Coast, Washington, D.C. area. There's a large abundance of companies, federal government contractors, and associations in this area. It was just natural for us to, look in our backyard first.
Yeah, very good. Chris Stark, he's president and CEO of Cetron. I'm going to have to let you go, Chris. Do you want to remind people out there to check out Cetron at CETROM.net? That's Cetron.net. Before I let you go, though, I want to put you on hold for just a minute. We want to get some information from you real quick. But, Chris, enjoyed having you on the program, and congratulations on the enormous growth.
Thanks, Kevin. I really appreciate it.
All right, when we come back, much more for you. Do want to remind you the best content here? It shows up over there at usdailyreview.com. While there, like it on Facebook, follow it on Twitter. You're listening to The Price of Business.